show in some sort of like event back in 2017, and in the YouTube video, he had an artist make graphics, and what they were doing was like he was making the beat and she was drawing to it.
I saw that video.
Kendrick knows how to play the NPC.
With the girl, with that girl, that was a nice girl.
Yeah. What I saw, I was like,
remember?
Yeah. When I saw it, I was like, Kendrick can make beats.
It's completely removing your ego. When you remove your ego, you allow yourself to open different chapters that you may not know about, that the person next to you may know about.
We're able to do this as artists. We're able to meet other talented people who are as obsessed about what they do as we are and meet in the middle somewhere and create something new.
You're in my head and I'm in your head at the same time. It's dope.
The location has an effect on my art. The audience has an effect on my art. The space is as relevant to the art as the art is to the space.
Being on stage performing, you see things. You see color, you see sounds, you're seeing the words reflect off other words. Her art has layers, and when you break my music down, it has layers. So it's a great hand-in-hand experience.
And he chooses not to use them in his songs?
He's a great, great, great composer. Great, great, great.
That's when I decided, oh man, I don't have to play every instrument in my albums to prove that I'm good. I really don't have to. I thought I did. I don't have to. It's an ego.
It's an ego thing, but you don't have to. If you have more great, you understood that you listen my album. I do the half the production, nightclubbing. I do half the production. My friend was a better musician than me. I just say, do this. I play some the first note of the album sometimes in the first part, and he finished the rest. Like I took this idea about this band, like Jamiroquai. Did you listen to Jamiroquai? Did you want to know that band Jamiroquai?
Oh, I thought you were talking about the singer Jamiroquai.
I mean, Jamiroquai is a band.
Jacaria. Oh, I thought it was just because they made a remix of Swimming Pools.
No, yeah, Jamiroquai is a band, but the lead singer is JK. It's JK who is the lead singer of the band.
Oh!
And is the guy who know how, he's not a real musician.
Okay.
But he know how, he's really, really good at directing his musician. He play some the first.
Like note. Michael Jackson.
Exactly, the same thing. He play the first note and his bassist. Yeah. That tank, Stuart Zender, complete the rest. That's the way he do. It's not he play all the instruments like Prince or Todd Rundgren, those type of guy. If you have the direction, if you have the idea, if you have the vision, you can recruit better musicians than you, and your idea is more polished. That people will have Tony Visconti for that. All his career, he has Visconti. So many guys have one guy who's very, very Frank Ocean. He have a white guy, I forgot the name. Frank Ocean also a white guy, Polish Italian. Tom York from Radio.
Même.
Vas-y, tu parlais d'eux.
Bob Marley, vocals and guitar, rhythm guitar, et c'est tout. But people talk about Bob Marley, so because he'll get the guitarist that played with with Stevie Wonder. He says, okay, fill in this space, fill in that space, fill in this space. He'll tell the drummer and bass of the Wailers, c'est son des jumeaux. Aston Barrett and Carlton Barrett.
D'accord, je la connais pas.
Deep and Move. No, faster, faster, faster. Less melodic. Ouais, ouais. Aston Barrett, c'est mon bassiste préféré. Il est mort la semaine après
la sortie du film.
D'accord. Ok. Je connaissais pas. Il faut que je m'intéresse à Bob Marley. Je n'ai pas encore commencé. Je vais annoter les albums dont tu vas parler, là. Exodus et... Les albums dont tu me parlais là. Et il faut que je commence à un peu Bob Marley.
Le meilleur album de Bob Marley pour moi, c'est Survival. L'album avec tous les drapeaux d'Afrique à l'époque. Parce que dans le cover, il y avait le drapeau de Zaïre au lieu du Congo. Et il y avait aussi d'autres choses. Donc... Mais ils n'ont pas changé, je crois que c'est vraiment un album 1979.
If you like To Pimp a Butterfly, you have to listen to the album of J. Scott Tyrell, like Winter in America. You're gonna like it also. What did you say?
Who?
J. Scott Tyrell, you have to listen, if you love To Pimp a Butterfly, you have to listen also J. Scott Tyrell. This album, Winter in America.
Yes, and all of the healers have been killed. Sent away.
Okay. Yeah.
Because it's To Pimp a Butterfly, the musicianship.
Winter in America. Je veux voir si c'est sûr.
The musicianship or Winter in America. Is very To Pimp a Butterfly is very inspired by the musicianship also. Also of the G. Scott Heron album. Kendrick avait samplé même pas le passé déjà G. Scott Heron. Le son Poor Man Dreams qui était dans Section 80, c'était un son de... C'est Peace Will Go With You, Brother, de Disco Tone qui l'avait samplé. Et quand tu écoutes les albums, là, Disco Tone et son gars qui était à côté de la Brian Jackson, un artiste là qui pêchait un peu toutes ces idées-là. La musique de Kendrick Lamar, de Butterfly, est très, 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 très similaire à ça. Et c'est un peu le même thème aussi. C'est toujours un thème un peu par rapport à la communauté noire, par rapport au truc, parfois. C'est toujours un peu la même chose. C'est pour ça que parfois, même souvent, je comprends même Kendrick Lamar aussi à J. Scott Tyrell dans sa manière, dans sa délire. J. Scott Tyrell was the spoken word guy. Many people say he's one of the first rapper. Many people say that he's one of the first rapper. For me, he was a spoken guy from the 70s. He knew how to sing.
Okay.
He knew how to sing also, but he was a very, very spoken word guy. So, the thing I like the most also about the way Kendrick, the delivery of Kendrick, he reminded me the delivery of G. Scott Tyrell. And he reminded me the delivery of a jazz musician. He's... His flow, his flow is like a keyboard guy or keyboard guy from jazz or a saxophonist. We talked yesterday about that song, Go Back Glasper. What's the name? It's for free, no?
Living in captivity, raised my cap, salary, telling me green is all I need, evidently all I see was spam and raw sorry.
It's free, need and free.
Yeah.
It was like,
for free.
You told me, Robert Glasper, about the keyboard.
Yeah, the keyboard was the last addition to the song. Even after the vocals of Kendrick, Because Kendrick vocally is doing what the keyboard would usually be doing in a song like For Free. So what Robert Glasper was doing was he was ad-libbing with Kendrick in a way.
It's very difficult.
That's why it's very minimal. The...
I don't know why to talk about it. I'm very, very emotional when I listen to Mortal Man. The last song of the album.
When shit hit the fan. When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan? When shit hit the fan, is you still a fan?
Mortal Man. Yeah.
It's 12 minutes, no?
What I like about Mortal Man is like the last released recording of Tupac's voice, right? Ever?
Yeah. And swallow the evil.
Right.
That's how I see it. My world is born. I see, and the ground is a symbol for the poor people.
Right.
The poor people is going to open up this whole world, swallow up the rich people. Because the rich people are going to be so fat, and they're going to be so appetizing. You know what I'm saying? Wealthy.
One of the last.
Yeah.
One of the last.
It's, well, before Taylor Made Freestyle. It's like a perfect, I'm joking. It's like a perfect close on this thing.
Yeah, it's a perfect close for the theme of the album. And
yeah, and also on...
Keep going.
And also on Tupac's story. Because when I heard that Kendrick got a recording of Tupac, I was like, oh man, he just downloaded an interview from YouTube. But then I learned that it was actually an unreleased recording that when Kendrick received, he went on YouTube everywhere. He looked everywhere to make sure that recording was completely new and unused. It's interesting. I wonder what kind of mechanical shit they had to do to like get his voice all perfect and stuff.